Staying in the U.S., and the Obama administration has announced a very ambitious plan to significantly reduce carbon emissions in the U.S. plant sector. Supporters of the plan say it will give Washington greater leverage to push countries like China and India to do more to fight climate change and bring down their emissions as well. Our Choi You-sun reports.
But today EPA is proposing a clean power plan that will cut carbon pollution from our power sector by using clean energy sources and cutting energy waste.
The Obama administration's new plan requires America's 1,000 power plants to reduce their carbon dioxide emissions to 30% of 2005 levels by the year 2030. Nearly two-fifths of electricity in the U.S. is generated by coal-fueled plants. Each U.S. state has a number of ways to achieve this. They can increase their power plants' heat rates, rely more on natural gas or other sources for energy, and raise energy efficiency. The Environmental Protection Agency says more than $90 billion U.S. dollars of climate and health-related costs will be saved from the plan, and up to 150,000 asthma attacks in children and over 3,000 heart attacks could be prevented.
Often these illnesses are aggravated by air pollution. Pollution from the same sources that release carbon and contribute to climate change. We've got to do more to reduce it.
Despite the government's assurances that the new rules will bring down electricity bills by 8% and encourage investment in new technologies, business groups and lawmakers from coal-reliant states oppose the initiative.
The administration has set out to kill coal and its 800,000 jobs. If it succeeds in death by regulation, we'll all be paying a lot more money for electricity.
After a period of public comment, the regulations will be finalized in June of next year, after which states can submit their own carbon reduction plans. Choi You-sun, Arirang News.